sempre mi c'è mai per cambiare.
Thank you.
Well, actually, I'm quite preoccupied with the idea of women finding freedom and women finding themselves. And I myself feel, as a woman, I don't feel fully free. And I'm always feeling like there's something inside of me which keeps holding me back. So it's this yearning for freedom that I wanted to explore. And I thought rather than exploring it through a world which is very similar to mine, where there are not so many external restrictions on one's freedom, why don't I explore it through a world where there are actually more external restrictions on a woman's freedom, and then look at this idea of being internally free and externally free. So it just sort of emerged like that.
Okay, on what ground is zeroed on the status of the flame, you know?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I guess with the Konkuna and Ratna, they were the first people I thought of for those parts, and I just, you know, sent them the script, and it was really quite a simple process. With the other two girls, we went through, you know, elaborate auditioning process. So my casting director, Shruti Mahajan and Parag Mehta, they worked, and along with my assistant directors, worked very, very hard on the casting of the film. And so that's how we sort of decided upon Ahana and Plabita. And all the male cast and all the other cast, I mean, really, I would give all the credit to my casting directors, because I did not have even one idea for casting vis-a-vis anyone apart from Konkan and Ratna. So all the others were like options that they sort of brought, and we tested people and all of that, yeah.
Do you think there will be a comparison, though, even the film called Pink, which released, you know, we also talk about women and their power, you know. Do you think there will be a comparison with your film with Pink?
Well, Pink told a wonderful story, and I would be very proud. It would be a very proud comparison with the film. But I think the two films are very, very different. I know because such few films in India are made about women, that the few films that are made, they always get clubbed together and be like, oh, this film is like that. But I think they're very, very different films. I really loved Pink, though I do. I did feel that eventually it was about, you know, Mr. Bachchan's character sort of saving the women, kind of a thing. So I think it had a different sort of connotation. Lipstick Under My Burkha is also much more independent film like that. It also tells the stories of four ordinary women and their search for freedom. And it's told very much from a very intimate female point of view. So, and also I think it talks about slightly different things, though thematically many things are, you know, of course, similar. But I think Pink spoke more about, you know, the idea of consent and how safe are women on the streets and things like that. And I think Lipstick talks about more about what is the freedom that a woman has within the four walls of her home, first and foremost. So I think it's more intimate in that sense. It's not so much about what you face when you step out of your house. It's more about what you face while you're inside the area that is supposed to be the most protected. But it's also fun and very colorful film, and it's actually quite a warm film. So I think, I would say that, you know, each film is different and each film is unique. But it's nice that, I mean, I feel there should be more and more films made about women and by women and for women.
The film, which has already won 11 international awards, and, you know, in its own country, it's surrounded by controversy. Do you feel set somewhere down there?
You know, I think in our own country, there's a lot of support for Lipstick Under My Burkha. I feel like I can't tell you the kind of messages I've constantly been getting from young women and lots of men and women, actually. So I feel like very supported with this film and the journey. I think the only chink in the armor has really been the CBFC and the whole idea of censorship. But I feel like the film has really got so much love from so many people across so many different countries, the way the film has been embraced. And I feel the most beautiful thing is that in India, people have not seen the film and they're still giving us so much love. I mean, without even having seen the film. So I think I feel very, very blessed, and I feel very encouraged. I feel 2017 times have really sort of changed. I feel people in India are very, very supportive of alternative voices in cinema. So I'm excited to see, you know, what's going to happen. And I feel what's very lovely is I feel like I'm really feeling like it's not just our release, but like I feel like it's everybody's film, you know, and I feel that's the feeling that people sort of have as well.
Okay, do you feel that the censor board or the people sitting on the seat are under pressure somewhere with the current government because they come with a ideology, you know?
You know, censorship is not something new. It's not like censorship has suddenly started happening. Censorship, we have, as a free and democratic country, we have actually been living with censorship for decades and decades. I mean, earlier you never even saw two people kissing. The two flowers would come and it would mean that the union has happened, which is, I mean, funny. But, so I am not of that opinion. I feel, actually, we were, after independence, we took on socialist principles in our economy. We had a sort of closed economy and our attitude was more like closed and we were, economically we were a closed country and it was like, I remember growing up, it was not very like okay to want so many things. So there was a little suppression and repression and all that. And we had took on all these Victorian kind of mindsets, which we borrowed from the British. The British left them behind. We are still living with that kind of a mindset. So I feel we have very archaic censorship guidelines and laws by the 1952 Cinematograph Act. And we have actually been living with censorship for a very long time. I feel what's happened is it's come into sharp focus now because also that there are many more independent films being made which are more international in nature. Also because content is like so open now. We watch so much more material from other countries. Stuff is available to us digitally. So I feel, even obviously as a free and democratic citizen of a free and democratic country, I also want the freedom to be able to make whatever I feel like, because I'm seeing people from other free countries making whatever they feel like. So that has also created a situation where now I feel many more things are being expressed in cinema. And this perhaps was bound to be like, it's like now I feel it's like we are reaching a crisis point that as a free and democratic country, do we want censorship or do we not want it? So I feel it's not something new. It was always there, but now I feel we have to decide as citizens of India in 2017 whether we want to claim our freedom and live in a free and democratic country or do we want to live with this moral guardianship. So I don't feel it's anything new. I think it's come into sharp focus now and I really think time's up on this censorship. We need to bid censorship a proper and clear goodbye and get into a process which is much more matter of fact in terms of certification. Yeah, that's what I would like to say.
Okay, there are so many, if I'll talk about a teaser or trailer, there are so many open scenes, you know, there's so many things. Does somebody came across and said, you know, the actor, I'm not comfortable doing this, or there'll be an awkward moment while picturizing it?
No, I think the intent of the script is very clear. There's no titillation in the film. It's not exploitative. It's not voyeuristic. It's very, very, excuse me, thoda sa soft bowling, please. I think the intent of the film is very, very clear. It's not exploitative. It's not voyeuristic. It's not titillating. This is a film about the intimate lives of four women. Four women looking at their own lives and sharing their experiences with us. So in my head, there was no confusion because there's no nudity. There's not even a cleavage shot in the film. The eyes of how the women are being looked at is not for the purpose of male fulfillment or objectification or anything. So I think it was very clear. I think the actors knew that from the word go. It was clear on paper. It was clear when they met me. It was clear. I think there was no confusion about that. Of course, it's difficult to do all kinds of scenes, not just intimate scenes. There are some other scenes in the film also, which, you know, were a challenge for all of us to sort of create the right moment. But I don't think there was any confusion in anyone's head. And these are all brave actors and they are very free-minded, independent, thinking, sensible actors. So, of course, they knew what... I mean, it was very clear on paper what we were going to do and how. And we worked out how we were going to shoot it. We did a lot of preparatory work, a lot of rehearsals, reading, workshops. So, I think that created a sense of trust and whatever, you know, issues were, So we together arrived at how are we going to shoot those scenes. So all of that was very, very clear. So I think everybody, I mean, I feel people were very comfortable shooting whatever they had to. What was required of them was very clear right from the word go. And we tried to create a warm and comfortable environment on set. So my camera person, my sound person, the costume person, the assistant directors. I think everybody worked very hard to create a very warm and comfortable environment for the actors. We had closed sets and there was a lot of trust. So I think it was not so difficult in that sense.
Could you just throw some light, you know, where Kumara is holding a mobile and, you know, there's a shot, there's a scene going on.
Ahana Kumra,
you know, uh-huh. If you can throw some light. It was that easy, you know, the way we have seen it. And it happens in India.
Well, I don't want to say too much so that it doesn't take away from watching of the film. But these are young people in our country and they're just being who they want to be. But in hiding, I would just want to say. So it's like they can do what they want, but they can't do it openly. And that's really what the film is about. That people are trying to live out their dreams, but they have to keep doing it secretly.
Okay, the positives, the vibe is really positive around the film. Do you think Half the Battle is won, or are you still nervous?
You know, as a filmmaker, the one is always nervous when your film is going to open out into audiences in your home country. I think, in some way, I think I'm a little less jittery emotionally because I've seen the film, the film has already traveled to I've lost the count, but more than 35 film festivals across the world. And I've been to many of them and I've seen, and I've physically seen the love that the film has got from so many audiences across so many different countries. And I've felt it. I've met those people and, you know, all of that. So I think that journey has is something that's making me a little less nervous, because at least I feel like it's not like nobody's ever seen the film. But yeah, I feel in India people really haven't seen the film. And I feel we've got so much support from so many quarters across the board in India. So I don't want I'm hoping that people go to the theatres on 21st July and they enjoy the film and they're able to engage with it. And I hope that people can, you know, because I feel like so many other things have been spoken around the film. But the film is actually just a very small, simple, colourful kind of film. So I just want people to go and enjoy the film actually.
Mr. Bachchan always supports women, you know, whether it is freedom of speech. But he always there, you know. Would you be interested in holding a special screening for Mr. Bachchan?
Yeah, Mr. Bachchan has been very, very kind. He's already tweeted our trailer. And yes, we will be holding a screening. We will be inviting him. I hope he has the time. And he can make time for us in his schedule and watch the film. We will be wanting to invite him for a screening for sure.
What message do you want to give to the audience while they come and be a part of your film?
Well, I really don't want the audience to feel like they're coming to watch a film because they're going to get a message. I want the audience to just come and for those 2 hours, experience the lives of these 4 women, their ups and downs, their tears, their laughter, their dreams, their passion, their heartbreak. And just be with them for those 2 hours. And I think at the end of those 2 hours, if people feel like they know these 4 women and they know what their lives are like, I think my work as a filmmaker is done.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.